try and record some stuff from here at Colin's house, so I have something to make a video out of. I don't want to be that guy that just, like, puts bullshit videos together, like, hey, I'm going to Starbucks, or hey, I'm at Home Depot, you know, like, I don't want to put videos out like that of just, like, just empty content, basically. I want to give you guys good content, you know, working on cars, like, you know, or being at events, or driving, you know, anything like that. Like, I want to give you guys good videos to watch, and I'm doing my best, so let me know if you guys are digging the videos so far, but I'm driving, so I'm going to let you go. You guys might recognize this car. They finally got the drive shaft in it, so Karen's been out driving it around. They don't have a shift knob yet, but yeah, it's running and driving. Pretty sweet. What's up, motherfuckers? Look at this. Look at this.
What's up, man?
No, just kidding. What's up, man?
Oh, you know, chilling. So, welded all this stuff back together. Colin accidentally cut too much out, so I had to weld some stuff back in. And had to weld in a filler piece in there. Primed it. We're going to seam seal it. And yeah, we just did a quick alignment on it. It needs 3 degrees of camber to fit because the overs he got are 70s.
Quick tees.
Quick tees for you. These are 70s and we had to bow them out to be like 90s. But yeah, we had it installed earlier with Clecos and stuff and had to pre-bow the bottoms of it to get the center to pop out. So tomorrow, hopefully, we'll have both sides welded, both overs put on. Maybe the rear bumper fit, we'll see. And then he wants these holes filled in this trunk. So, yeah, we'll be back tomorrow messing with this thing. What's going on over there, Colin? What are you doing?
Did these intercooler mounts right here.
He's doing pull-ups on his intercooler. What a maniac.
Dude, look at that shit, bro. It came out nice. Yeah,
bro.
Little bottom ones, man. Fucking solid.
Good job, Colin.
Right on.
Good job, good job.
Mucho trabajo.
Mucho trabajo. So we got the rear on. It's the nice hardware that we're running. Put rivets on the bottom, though, but... yeah, it fits fucking really good. Fitment's on point. So then we'll check out the other side. Just finished priming this side. This side had been in a collision before, so it was kind of all messed up, but...
collision calling.
Yeah, calling collision. Not so yet. Yeah, got it all tacked together, just letting the primer dry, and then we'll go back and seam seal it like we did the other side. Yeah, he'll be able to fucking... tuck 20s on this thing if he wants to. Jesus.
High five, I like.
Yeah. So now we got it all seam sealed in. So it's not gonna leak water or anything like that. And then I got one hole drilled. And I'm gonna go ahead and Cleco the overfender on. These things are awesome. It's basically like a removable rivet. So they make these in 3/16 and 1/8 inch. These are the 1/8 inch ones. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the top center one in here on the panel, and then we'll bow the bottom in. So we'll pull this forward and we'll push this one back to get the center of it to pop out. And then we'll clamp it on, drill holes, Cleco it all in, and then put nut zerts in it to do the final attachment. And we're just about done. All right, so that's a wrap on this thing. He's got the front fenders coming in next week, and then we'll put the skirts and the front bumper on, build him a bash bar. But the rear end's done. Looks good. This side was all smashed to hell, so getting that side to fit was a little challenging, but this side looks really good. It's going to be sweet. You'll see this car in more videos for sure. So this is going to be part 3 of do-it-yourself over fenders. I did the little bit of mold correction that I had to do. So now what I'm working on is I'm getting ready to prime it, just mixing up the primer And gonna prime it so then that way everything kind of stays sealed in, and I'm not, like, when I'm popping panels off, I'm not gonna like pull little chunks of body filler out. Hopefully that's the plan anyways. So yeah, getting closer with this. It's gonna look good on there. I can't wait for the wheels to actually be covered up and for it to not be Mexi flush. It's gonna be great. Now that the mold is primed, the next step I did was I waxed it, just rubbed it on, made sure the whole thing had a nice even coat of wax all over it, and then I brushed on this PVA. It's basically like a mold release. So then when you put your gel coat on, it's going to have that green color PVA on the outside of it, but that just like, it's water soluble, so you just you know, wash it off, and then it'll be it'll just be the white gel coat. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start mixing up this gel coat, and I'm gonna coat this thing. I'm gonna give it a pretty generous coating, so there's like a lot of gel coat. You could sand down to block it if you want to and stuff like that. So yeah, gel coat, and then I'm gonna try and do one of these today, like the whole thing, lay the fiberglass on it and everything. We'll see how motivated I'm feeling, but so far so good. Progress is good today. What are you doing, Bill?
Making some shock mounts.
Ooh, some shock tabs.
Yeah, the old ones were big and bulky. They came up here, interfered with the steering. Well, they actually interfered on the passenger side, not on the front side. I was gonna switch to like a shock hoop setup, but it's probably just easier to run like this.
Yeah.
Something like that. In there.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Shock tabs for the motherfucking win.
Yeah.
I just gotta do the other side and weld them in.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's done, right?
No, I wish. I wish that was all, but that's all I gotta really do for more fabrication side of stuff, but yeah, there's still lots of stuff to do on this bad boy.
I'm happy to see you working on it. So, got the first overfender. I got the fiberglass laid up, just waiting for it to dry, and then I'm gonna mark it and cut it and pop it off the mold. But yeah, cutting it first, like laying the fiberglass on, then relieving it where it needed to be, and then putting like a backing piece in, helped out a bunch. Laid a lot flatter than when I did the mold. So yeah, it's just a waiting game now, and then pop the bitch out the mold, see how it looks.
So how'd that first one turn out, hon?
First one turned out okay. There's some adjustments I need to make. I did a bad job with the gel coat, and it shows, and a couple little areas of the mold where I had to do like little touch-up repairs got pulled out with this piece because I didn't use enough wax. But for the first piece, I'm pretty happy with it, and it's super flexible, which is exactly what I wanted. Like, it's super, super flexible. Nice.
So it's really flexible.
Yeah, it's gonna be really resilient when I you know, if and when I hit it. But for the first one, I'm stoked on it. I just gotta do the other side. Wednesday night, it's about 9 o'clock. Just finished up the first side. Oh, wow. Good zooming in. So there are some things that I could improve on with the mold and how I did this. I didn't let the PVA set up long enough. So the PVA does have to completely dry before you put your gel coat on. And it was just kind of, I rushed it a little bit and the gel coat didn't set up right, and that's why I had so many imperfections on the outside. So I just sanded it all down, put a little bit of body filler in some touch-up spots, sanded it again, and then primed it, and now I have it clecoed on. And all in all, for this being the very first one, I'm pretty stoked on it. I think it looks awesome. And it's super thin, so it's really, really flexible, like, which is awesome. Kind of exactly what I wanted. So, yeah. Hopefully, you know, if and when I smash this thing, these will survive. I mean, it's not like I don't have the mold for it, though. But, yeah, I'm going to come back tomorrow and do the other side. And then I also got to build a center console for this thing. And I got to get the windshield put in. So, not this weekend. Today's Wednesday, not this weekend. But next weekend is Memorial Day, and it's round one of competition. Damn, I am filthy. So trying to get the truck ready, resealed the valve covers today. Let's see if this light, Billy helped me out and resealed the valve covers. The engine bay looks really, really nice. He also whipped up this little, intake mount that I have to weld on, but yeah, getting closer and closer and closer all the time. And then I fixed this fender. So basically, I just hammer dollied it back, and then I cut the opening just a little higher. I need to go back and clean it up, but hopefully now the tire won't munch the fender too bad. But, yeah, I'm super happy about that. I think that looks awesome. Yeah, I don't know. For some reason, on the do-it-yourself overfenders videos, those got more hates and more, like, more haters and more views than any of my other videos. So I'm assuming a lot of people like it, and I'm also assuming that a lot of people that were watching it didn't quite understand what I was trying to do, because I ended up having to explain myself a lot in the comments, like, watch the video, watch the video, watch the video, it's a mold, I'm making a mold. And people were like, oh, Tyler Falco or whatever did it first, but Tyler Falco did not do what I did. He just fucking put foam on there and then put fiberglass over it and left it. He didn't make a mold. So this is a final product piece right here. There's nothing behind it. Shop again. Today's Thursday. I have a car coming back from paint on Monday, so I kind of, and I have plans tomorrow actually too. So today and some of this weekend is pretty much all I have left to get the truck ready for round one. And one of their requirements I saw in their tech was that you have to have working headlights, taillights, and brake lights and all that. So I basically had to make a harness. Wiring harness for the rear lights. It runs along here. I have this brake pressure switch wired up now, so the brake lights come on. And then this wiring harness running along here, going up through a grommet in the floor where I have the O2 and the Speedo going through as well. Yesterday, Billy wired up the headlights, and they're in the cab. And that harness is now up in the cab. I just need to wire it to a relay and a switch that I already installed. Also, so I got this one on with the nice hardware that I like to use. The reason I like to use these so much is because with rivets, I just feel like it puts too much pressure in such a small area. And you also can't control how much pressure a rivet takes. It just goes until the stud pops out of it. So with these, I like that it's like a bigger surface area, and that you can adjust how tight you're going with it too. So I think those are trick. I have them on Elizabeth's car, did them on Colin's car, And now they're on this. And I also had a few extra, so I like threw them on the fender and stuff like that up in the engine bay where you could see it. So while I'm wiring up the lights, I'm waiting for this gel coat to dry so I can lay the piece for the other side. Yeah, it looks so derpy without it now that I've seen it with an overfender. Like, that just looks like total shit. I can't believe I drove it. But yeah, so after I get all this done, I need to make a center console too, because I have that fuel line running along the center console, or the tunnel, and Drift Colorado Rules wants it completely covered, so I'm going to try and bust out a center console for it today too. What else? I need to do an alignment. I need to get the windshield put in, and I need to do some rear suspension adjustments, and then that's probably all I'm going to have time for, and hopefully it goes well. We'll see. So just got the Audi off the trailer, check the tire pressure, cut off these two D-rings that were back here that always made it a bitch getting the drift truck on. Now we are going to go pick up a hot rod, like it's a 37 Plymouth or something like that, for the neighbor with the hot rod that I'm building next door. This is going to be next year's project. I think it's just a body, a frame, and some doors. But yeah, and then someone's coming to borrow the trailer. You'll see who that is in a little while. But he's going to be going out of state and needs to rent a two-car trailer. So we're going to go get this hot rod. So this is the thing. This is next year's project. We got doors and two trunks in the back of the Suburban. But someone already started kind of modifying it. Like, they did a notch, and they did a spring mount in the front. And I think that's about it for modification. They cut the floor out of it. We're going to be chopping it, channeling it, body dropping it. It's going to be a killer rat rod. Oh, and it's got bullet holes. Blow, blow, blow. You pay extra for those. Yeah, it's going to be cool. Here comes trouble. If you know who that is, you know who that is. So Trevor is more observant than I, and he was looking underneath the trailer and saw that all the fucking U-bolts were loose. So we had to go through and put new nuts on just about all of them and torque them all down and tighten them. The tires are a little close to the shackles, so we put some white spray paint on the tire. So when he's driving down the road, if he feels like checking it, he can look at that and see if it's been rubbing the tire at all. Because it just about ate through the spare tire. Or not the spare tire, this was a tire that was on it, and it ate through it pretty good, so we threw the spare on it. So he should be good to go now. He's got big dirty. So he's going to like Kentucky and Minnesota or some shit like that, picking up two cars. I don't think I'm gonna tell you guys what it is. If you want to find out what he's picking up, follow his channel, MotionAutoTV. Yeah. Those are the guys right there. So,
those are big secret projects, right?
Yeah. Top secret. So, yeah, he's going to be gone all weekend with the trailer, so.
Yeah, appreciate you letting me borrow, too.
Yeah, no problem.
This makes my life way easier, because I was going to do some, like, ghetto stuff to my trailer, like pull the hitch, and, like, pull the tow dolly, and, like, all that stuff.
Yeah.
I remember, I was like, man, I hope Brandon didn't sell that trailer. And so, right on.
Yeah. So, at least someone's getting to use the trailer, since I don't ever fucking use it. So, But safe travels to him.
Yeah.
We'll see him in the next video when he comes back. And
so, yeah. I won't have him on the trailer, but I'll have pictures.
Yeah. So. Yep.
Good behind Big Dirty.
Yeah. It needs to be a permanent fixture behind Big Dirty.
I know.
So let's get some action shots. You guys probably can't hear me very well.
I am your father.
Super exciting stuff.
The second one came out much nicer than the first one.
We did some things different. Let's get a look at it. I shouldn't have turned it. I'm sorry. Looking really good.
War paint.
That's racist.
What?
That's racist.
That's racist.
That's racist, guys.
I'm sorry.
Tell them how racist that is.
I'm sorry.
Cut the slow-mo.
Yeah, that'll be slow-mo. Mm.
We use like super laser accuracy cutting methods here.
Mm-hmm.
Only the best. That missile works. Look at this calibrated CNC marking system. Just gotta upload the files to the computer.
You dick.
Focus, you piece of shit.
You gotta press left.
I am pressing left.
You're fucking killing me.
Tell him how straight that is, guys. Tell him.
It's super not straight, alright? But it's mine. The ones I sell will be nicer, I promise. I'm just in a rush.
It's all fucking like dusty and hard to mark.
No shit. It's all dusty, huh?
Fuck you.
Look at poor Vert. Look how dusty she is.
I blow her off every like once a week.
Actually, you're right. Like, it looks pretty good. Yeah, it looks pretty clean.
I blow her off once a week because I care.
Like, shit, I'm gonna have to do some work on it.
So, I didn't explain before exactly what a nutzert is and, you know, how it's used. It's a special tool, a lot like a pop riveter, but instead it has this collet that you can turn. So, once you install the nutzert, you could actually, like, extract the tool from it. How I like to do this is I go not all the way down, because if it's all the way down, then you don't have any room to start crushing it, and it kind of just makes it a little bit harder. So if you give yourself a little bit of a gap, it gives you like a little more leverage. And then I'll just waste one now to show you guys how it works. But basically, it has a little flange.
Serrated, yes.
It has a little flange here that sits on the top of the panel. And then the serrations kind of mushroom and grab the backside of the panel. So show you how it works. Just like that. And you can see how the serrations came up to the flange and kind of grabbed it. And then once you're ready to take it out of the panel, you just turn this. And boom, it's free. And then this piece is permanently attached to your sheet metal.
Yeah, very cool way to put some nuts into sheet metal without having to weld anything or get too fancy. All you need is the tool, the proper sized riv nuts, and a drill bit to drill the holes out to fit the riv nuts in there.
And for these, I believe it's 25/64, and these are 6 mil. What I did was I just took a micrometer and or a set of dial calipers and measured it and then figured out what size drill bit I needed. Because they're all different sizes. So, and then I'll do this one since it's a single layer and it'll probably go in a little easier. So, good crush on that. Bam. And it's essentially the same thing as welding a nut on. But if you end up stripping it or breaking it, then you can just drill it out with the 25 64ths or whatever drill bit again and then put a new one in, which is nice. Okay. And then you don't have to worry about like corrosion protection too, because if you were to weld something, you'd have to prep the surface down to bare metal and then weld it and then put primer on it, and then for this you don't. So
yep, quick and easy.
Quick and easy. So this is going to be it for the Overfender Part 3 video. Hope you guys enjoyed it and learned a lot. I learned a lot doing it. So sanded all the gel coat on this one, so it's all nice and smooth. Pretty rad. This one definitely turned out a lot better than the first one, straight out of the mold. So me and Billy banged out a quick alignment on this thing. It was pretty far off, but it's all better now. Those toe plates, if you drift, get these, because they're awesome. They are invaluable. And then put some of those nice fasteners on the fender. And got this side to fit pretty good. So, next, I still have to finish the center console. I'll show you guys where that's at. So I still have to make it go forward, like up under the dash, and then make the opening for the shifter, and then actually mount it. And then I have to mount a fire extinguisher somewhere in there too. Have to get the windshield still. Just a bunch of little like nitpicky sort of items to be ready for the thin air event at Pike's Peak. But hope you guys enjoyed this video. Definitely a lot of progress on the truck in this video. Seems like people like the drift truck videos. So I hope you don't mind that this video is long. See you guys in the next one.